For millennia, biodiversity has been recorded unintentionally in religious or decorative art in ancient communities across the globe. Closer to home, these included the rock art by San and Khoi artists, as well as depictions of plants, animals, and even mushrooms, like those in the Mapungubwe collection. At present, biodiversity most often is defined and quantified by numbers of species. And for this, we use the names of formally described species. This globally accepted way in which we classify and name species dates back to about 500 years ago, when European biologists started to systematically document species. Various forms of art played a very important role in these species descriptions. Initially, line drawings were converted to print, but later also to full-color paintings. Some of these original illustrations are preserved with specimens of, example, plants in herbarium collections or in insect collections. In Fabi, the focus is on plant health, and most of these diseases are caused by microscopic fungi. We have described more than 500 new species of fungi and several new insect species over the past 20 years. We initially made use of line drawings and black and white photographs. Currently, we most often use color photographs and more computer-generated imaging. Biodiversity can often be missed by the naked eye, and therefore academic art has a hugely important role in translating and communicating the complexities of biodiversity in a way that is both understandable and aesthetically pleasing, not only in educating our students, but also in creating awareness about biodiversity among the general public.